What we're going to be doing here today is preparing some underwear for burial in the ground. And we do this to demonstrate how bioactive our soil can be. There's some things that you need to know before you start this exercise. And the first thing is, sometimes smaller is better. So I like to use either medium or small men's cotton underwear. And it has to be 100% cotton so that the microbes will eat it. If you use larger underwear, you have to dig a lot bigger hole, and that can be very problematic if the soil is hard. The next thing I do is label each pair of underwear so that I can identify which site it came from and the date that it was buried. So the site that we're going to be using right now is the Beef Educational Unit, or BEU, number 2. So we repeat this exercise at 3 different locations, each with a different soil type. And we bury the underwear over 8 weeks. So one pair goes in at 8 weeks. This is the 4-week set. And then I'll do another pair in 2 weeks, 2 weeks before we dig them up. So I have the site and the date on the band of the underwear. The next thing I do is poke a hole right below the elastic. And I put a length of flagging tape through that hole. And this is going to allow me to be able to find the underwear in 4 weeks when I come to dig it up. This one end of this will stick up just barely through the surface of the soil so that I can see where it is. And again, I label this the same way that I label the band, with the location and the date. Okay, so now we are ready to bury our underwear. I mark the site with a temporary fence post, and in this case, because we are in a pasture where there have been cattle and could be cattle in the near future, I have an electric wire running to the main fence so the cattle don't pull my fence post up, because this is how I find where the underwear are. Normally, I clear away a small area so I can see the ground where I'm working, and then we're gonna dig our slit. We don't dig a hole, so we're not truly burying the underwear like you would bury a casket, but we want to get a slit in the soil that the underwear will fit in and that allows really the maximum amount of soil to underwear contact without disturbing the soil. So hopefully there's no rocks right here. You'll know that if there are, if I tip over very quickly.
So the goal here is to get the underwear in contact with the soil without causing too much soil disturbance. And you can see from my little graphic here that the center of the slit needs to be about 9 inches deep, and that accommodates the crotch of the underwear. On the sides, it only needs to be about 6 inches deep because the underwear is not as tall there. Once you get your slit dug in the soil, you just stick the underwear on the shovel and push it down into the slit. Continue to work on the shovel, working it down gradually so you don't tear the underwear. And eventually you will get the whole depth of the underwear into the soil. I start in the center and then I move from side to side, gradually working it down until all you can see is the teeny bit of the elastic band sticking out from the soil surface. Once I get to this point, I will make sure it's all tucked in really well, and then I will take my flagging tape with the label information on it and tuck it down in between the 2 pieces of elastic so that it's impossible for any critters to get at. The other piece of flagging tape I leave sticking out of the ground just about 1 inch or 2 so that I can find the underwear when I come back to dig it up. I stomp on the soil to close up the slit and make sure that a cow can't possibly find that little piece of tape to pull up the underwear. And then we will be ready to move on to our next site.
This is our site that gets heavily used. We're in a holding lot. There is grass here and the soil is covered, but it is too short, in my opinion, to be a good, useful pasture. So what we find in this site might be different than what we find in the other sites, one of which is a very well-managed pasture and one of which is a very heavily tilled soil. So what I'm going to do is dig up these underwear. I have them marked. The camera probably can't see it, but there's a little piece of yellow flagging tape sitting up right here on the top of the soil where I've put this in the ground, so that's how I know where to find it. And I'm going to go into the ground about 3 inches from that seam in the soil. These were buried basically vertically, so it's like I put a little slot in the soil and put the underwear in straight up and down, or at least that's the goal. When you dig them up, you have to remember that hopefully the soil microorganisms have eaten the cotton on the underwear, not the elastic. So it might be very fragile. So what I do is I come out about 3 inches from where I buried it, and I just dig in another slit, kind of loosen the soil from against the underwear. Hopefully you don't hit any rocks. I take the clod out. I try to save the sod so I can put it back and not leave a big hole in whatever area I do this demonstration. If you're doing this on your own farm or on a private farm, you don't want a big ankle sprainer in your pasture. So after I get the basic sod out, I kind of use my hands to dig down and find the underwear. On this tag, I have a date. So this was buried on May 14th, which was about 4 weeks ago. So after I get this side loose, I basically do the same thing on the other side. And then I start looking for the little pieces of loose cotton that may have become detached. So we want to try to recover as much of it as we can. There's an earthworm. That's a good sign. So here's our underwear. Now, this doesn't look especially degraded, but you can see that it has had contact with the soil. So that could be possibly an indicator that there's not a lot of flora in the soil, or it could be that it was too dry, or if you did this with cotton, non-cotton underwear, you'd see this because microbes don't eat nylon or other artificial things. So the other thing you need for this day is 3 bags. And this was the second burial date at this site, so I'm putting it in my quart-size Ziploc bag with burial date number 2 on it. After I get it out, I kind of put the sod back as much as possible. This is really heavy clay right here. When I bury these, I normally do them in a T relative to my post, which marks the total location so you can return easily to this site. So I had a pair this way, and I've got a pair going each direction from the wire. There is an electric wire attached to this post. I don't know if that shows or not, but this is an actively used piece of land, and I don't want the cows pulling up my post or digging up my underwear, which sometimes they do if they're not buried well. So I put an electric wire on it, and that ensures that they leave it alone. It's okay if they graze over the top of it. I just don't want them pulling on my flagging tape. A great exercise to do with 4-H or ag classes in schools, or you can use it for extension demonstrations talking about soil health. Because in theory, when the underwear is still here completely after 4 weeks, it indicates there might be a lack of microbial activity. And honestly, what we find from year to year varies quite a bit. If the soil's too dry, things don't degrade well. If there's too much moisture, things might not degrade well. So I can see, this is the first set that I buried back on April 14th. So this has been in the ground for 8 weeks. But after 8 weeks in the soil, the microorganisms have had lots of time to snack.
quite often. In a real, real healthy soil, all you'll find left is the elastic. Got a little bit more left than that here today, obviously. After 8 weeks in the ground, this is what we have left at this site. You can see there's been a lot of disappearing cotton here. But again, not as much as you would expect in a healthy, not abused location. So that goes in that bag. And we're ready to put this back and go on to the third set. All right, our last pear has been in the ground for 2 weeks, and it's right over here. So since our 4 week pear was still pretty much all here, we would anticipate that our 2 week pear would also be mostly here, and indeed they are. Could probably take these home and give them a good bleaching and washing and put them on tomorrow. So then I put my most recent pear, which is usually the greatest volume of cotton left, in the larger of my three bags. Stick the other two inside so they're all together. These are labeled with the site, the date of interment, and then the main bag I put the date of exhumation on. So that's the process of that. Back, and then the last thing I do is take up my post and hot wire, and then we will be ready to be done.
So after we've dug up all of our underwear, we can compare the three different locations, which I will refresh your memory as to what we actually did. So we have these three sets that were buried in a well-managed pasture, as you can see here. This pasture is periodically grazed to an appropriate forage residual height, and then the cattle are removed and the grass is allowed to regrow. Our heavy use lot, which you just saw these underwear, some of them dug up from, is grass covered but heavily used, so the soil is likely compacted and the ground cover is not suitable to keep cattle fed and hungry and happy. So the final site, which we didn't actually shoot any video at, is a highly tilled soil in which this year the management is such that all they're doing is tilling to keep the weed population down. So there's no ground cover other than a little bit of weeds, and the soil is a heavy clay just like it was in our heavy use lot. So the top row of underwear here is those that were in the ground for only 2 weeks. So these two pair you can see from our heavy use lot and our tilled crop, our tilled no crop field. Basically the whole underwear is there. I could put these in the washing machine and with a little Clorox, my husband could probably wear them. These on the other hand, you can see that there's some cotton missing. So what's happening here is that the microorganisms and fungi that actually live in the soil are using the cotton as a food source. Cotton is made up out of cellulose, which is a carbohydrate, just like potatoes or bread. So the fungi and the bacteria use this carbohydrate source for energy to continue their survival. Obviously, the longer that it stays in the ground, the more time the soil microbiota have to chow down on the underwear. So that's why you see by this 8 week set here, where there is a large population of microbiota, all the cotton has been eaten. So the reason that we see different amounts of degradation is that soil is able to support different amounts of microbial population. The more compacted and tilled the soil becomes, the less likely it is that those little microorganisms can survive. They are aquatic animals, and a highly tilled soil a lot of times becomes very dry, so there may not be enough water there to support their lives. So they end up dying, and you don't see very much degradation. And when you do, it's like here, largely down in at the bottom of the underwear. 8 weeks out, they've had more time. We may have had some additional rain, which helps them out. So you do see some degradation almost everywhere that you put soil in the ground.